start glamming ourselves. Guys, my voice is a little too cranky still because I'm still recovering, but I had to get this video up for you guys, so kindly bear with me. I started off with a St. Ives moisturizer. Moisturizer is the key, guys. Never skip on using a moisturizer, never ever. For my primer, I went with Too Faced Hangover Primer, and after 5 minutes of wearing that primer, I went up with my LA Girl Orange Corrector around my mouth and under my eyes, as I've got dark circle and pigmentation. For my foundation, I used Too Faced Born This Way mixed in with Armani Maestro foundation. All the products shade names and the full name of the detail of the product will be mentioned in the description box, so kindly check the description box, guys. This is one of my favorite thing to do, to mix one drop of Maestro foundation to any of my high-end foundation, and it makes my foundation glide on so good and make it last for the longest. I have never shared this secret before, but yeah, that is one of my best secret to do. I've filled in my eyebrows off camera with ABH Pro Duo in the shade Ebony, and to set them in place, I'm using ABH Clear Brow Gel. It's everything is wiped off from the packaging because it's used and abused. Dancing, yes, yes, you have to dance. It was my husband's birthday, by the way. If you have seen my vlog, you know I got ready because it was my husband's birthday. I surprised him on his birthday. Do check out my vlog, guys. And I primed my eyes with eyeshadow crayon, which was from Sephora. Secret Boudoir is the shade. And to set it in place, you can use any setting powder. For my eyes, I went with Urban Decay's Naked Basics palette. First, I took these two shades and applied onto the crease to add warmth to my crease, and then fluffing it out and blending everything in together with a clean fluffy brush. I like to do this step after every eyeshadow I use it on my crease. This is one of my favorite kind of looks to go these days. Messed up, like very messy halo eyes. I'm loving it. And I mixed a cool tone and a warm undertones together because I wanted to use silver glitter, so that is why I mixed cool tones and warm tones onto my crease and created this mixture. And I went with this slate grayish color. It was very patchy, it wasn't too pigmented, so I struggled a lot to apply it all over my lid. And you can see I'm trying a lot to build it up, but then I wasn't too happy, but then still I tried and make it work. I'm taking these two shades and, you know, elongating my outer crease because I wanted that winged eye effect look. As you saw in the pictures, I had that elongated winged eye effect onto my eyes. I love it. And for the glitter, I went with this Tarte's Rainforest of the Sea palette. First, I took a little bit of NYX glitter, applied in the middle of the middle of my lid, and then with my fingers, I took the glitter, the gray one, the Stargazer gray glitter, and it sticked, and it lasted for so long. I love this NYX glitter glue, highly recommend it. Then I'm taking that grayish, dark gray shade again, applying it onto the corners of my eyes, and just blending all the things together because I don't want that defined halo eyes. I wanted messy, smoky halo eyes, as you can see. And then tight lining my upper and lower waterline with Plum Nature Studio Kajal. This is one of my favorite kajals these days. I have stopped using my Maybelline Colossal Kajal. And then I curled my eyelashes. And for my mascara, I went with Maybelline, the Colossal Big Shot Volume Express Mascara. This is currently one of my favorite mascaras to use. It's not very lengthening or anything, but I love that how it makes my lash looks very natural and easy. This is one of the most comfortable eyelashes in the world, Red Cherry Wispy Lashes. And to hide the lash band, I went with the you can use any colored any waterproof eyeliner, and I used Color Bar one. And for highlighting under my eyes, I went with the concealer Tarte Shape Tape in the shade Medium. I applied under my eyes, onto my forehead, and little bit onto my chin, blending it out with this Bonito's Magic Blender. I don't know why they have stopped selling this blender on Amazon. They need to restock this one more time. This is one of the most amazing beauty blenders, most affordable and amazing. And to bake that concealer, I'm gonna bake because I wanted this makeup to last for long. So I'm gonna bake for 10 minutes onto my face and then wiping it off. I use Laura Mercier's translucent setting powder, by the way. For my bronzer and contouring, I'm taking Kat Von D's shade in light palette, taking these two shades, applying it onto my cheeks, on my forehead, on my jaws, and also using I am dancing a lot on that day actually, and I use the same shade for my nose as well, and then taking these two shades, mixing in together and smoking my lower lash line, and connecting the outer edge to the lower lash line, as you can see, so that it gives that elongated eye look. I really loved the eyes on that day, just blending everything in together so that it looks smooth and nice. Yes, once it is done, for the bronzer I went with NYX matte bronzer. This is in the shade deep 10. Yes, I'm gonna bronzing my face wherever I've contoured. And for my lower lash mascara, I use the same mascara which I use for my upper lashes. And yes, that is what is doing I'm doing. And then to set my makeup in place, I went with my favorite Urban Decay's All Nighter setting spray. I cannot live without this stuff. I actually bath. I haven't cut the clip because I wanted you guys to see that how much I used it. For the highlighter, I went with Becca and Jaclyn Hill face palette. I used the Champagne Pop, and for the blush as well, I used the same blush shade from the palette, the middle one. I'll show you in a second. This one, and I really love this blush. This is one of my favorite go-to blushes of the 2018, and I'm cracking open my new Tatcha Dewy Skin Mist. If you've seen my vlog, you know I have gone through my 4 bottles, and whenever I open any new bottle, I have to check before spraying it onto my face, otherwise it will leave white residue onto the face. For the outfit, I was wearing a Shein blouse that you saw. It has got tassels. For the earrings, I am wearing these earrings from, I got it from Singapore, and before stepping out of my house, I have to clean my hairline and my hair with a makeup removing wipe because I've got makeup all over. So I have to clean it up. And for lining my lips, I went with my favorite Color Bars lip liner in the shade Chocolate Brown. For my lipstick, I went with Urban Decay's Wise Liquid Lipstick. This is in the shade Back Talk. It's very light, mauve-y color. Because of my dark lip liner, it was looking a little too dark, but I love it. And I am curling my hair. Actually, I've got only 15 to 20 minutes, and I was not knowing that what I should do to my hair. Then I saw my curler and I was like, let's curl it out. It was very messy, but then I had to make it work because my hair was very oily from the roots, so I have to make it work. So I just curled very roughly. I curled it. It wasn't too very precise. Yes. After it's done, I'm gonna use my L'Oreal Boosted Spray for adding the texture, and to set my curls and to hold them in place, I am using L'Oreal Elnett. And for adding shine to my hair, I went with Matrix BioLage Serum. I spilled it onto my table and my clothes. I'm gonna just rub it and juice up my hair. Just like that. And once that is done, for my perfume, I went with Jimmy Choo's EDT. I'll link it down, the name of this EDT, in the description box. All the products and the links to the products will be mentioned in the description box. Kindly check the description box. I was wearing this blouse from Shein. I really, really loved it. So that's it for this makeup look, you guys. I really, really hope that you have liked it. Let me know in the comment section how you guys like it. Do not forget to subscribe. If you're not subscribed yet, hit the notification bell for more such videos, and you can also follow me on Instagram. And yes, with that being said, guys, I will see you very, very soon in my next video, guys. Bye.